DJ at a club. All right. Welcome back into the Sports Source. We're talking about Derek Dooley when he was giving shower instructions years ago. Southeast Termite and Pest Control brings you this this segment. As the new year starts, get ready to protect your property at home or at work from pesky insects that can damage your building or carry disease. Locally owned, family owned since 1971, Southeast Termite and Pest Control. You can't beat them. They do fantastic work. I use them in my home. I can tell you, they are outstanding. Southeasttermite.com to learn more. All right, no overtime segment today. We'll get back into the overtime thing next week, but it's New Year's Eve day, so we're all going to get out of here. The SEC, guys, very quickly, SEC 1-3 in bowl games so far. Some take bowl records as a real good gauge of how strong a conference is. Others say it's all about individual matchups, pay them no mind. I'm somewhere in the middle. Where are you guys on the how much you watch those records for bowls? Do you pay a lot of attention to them?
I'm in the middle. I mean, if you have a record that is just a disaster like the Pac-12, that doesn't speak very well for the conference. Like the SEC, some are saying, well, notice that they haven't played that many games. So to this point, meaning they're in better bowl games, but you also had more teams like Florida and Tennessee that didn't make it this year. So I'm in between. It's something you use to brag if you do well, and it's something that you put to the side if you don't have a great record.
Big Ten is bragging. Pac-12 is saying nothing.
Yeah, I'm kind of in Josh's camp. I think it's a small reflection. God, the Big Ten's doing really well, aren't they? And they deserve to be doing well. When I look recently at the SEC matchups, I actually picked the SEC to have a losing record in bowl games. And in part, Texas A&M didn't have the coach, right? So sometimes you've got coaches that aren't even there. Mississippi State surprised me by winning when their coach left. So I didn't think the SEC would have a winning record.
On that A&M thing, I thought this was interesting. If Arkansas backed out of the deal with John Chavis the way Tennessee did with Kevin Steele because he had a bad bowl game, that would be the second job that Dave Clawson cost John Chavis. Once when they worked together and once when he beat him so badly in a bowl. Very quickly, do you guys pay attention to it?
Just some.
Just a little?
Just a little.
Yeah, I'm in the middle. Being in the middle is my general philosophy. So it applies to this.
All right, last question very quickly. Tomorrow at 5 o'clock, number 3 Georgia versus number 2 Oklahoma in Pasadena. Then it's number 4 Alabama and Jeremy Pruitt versus number 1 Clemson down in New Orleans. Who you guys got in the title game? Just give me the teams.
Georgia and Clemson.
Georgia and Clemson.
Alabama, Oklahoma.
Alabama, Oklahoma.
Georgia, Clemson.
Okay.
I've got Clemson and Oklahoma.
I got Clemson and Oklahoma too.
Well, Clemson defensive line is going to be something.
I can't stand Baker Mayfield, and that makes me think he's going to, even though he's been sick, I think he's going to light up Georgia. We'll see.
We'll see.
The SEC will start looking a lot stronger if they wind up with the two teams in the national championship game. 2017 was a terrible year, even for my voice, which keeps cracking like Peter Brady. Never been so glad to put one under the ground. So bye-bye 2017. Adios. Here's hoping for a better 2018 for Vol fans out there. Been saying that for several years now. Maybe 18 will be the one that turns for you. Want to wish all of you, on behalf of all of us, a very happy and safe New Year's Eve tonight. Be smart out there. Have a good time. Be smart. And we will see you next Sunday right back here at 11 a.m. for the Sports Source. We leave you with our own special countdown as the year ends. See you next Sunday.